We are going to discuss the topic formal method in this video. If you feel some irritating sound in the background, kindly avoid it because my mic is creating problem. Let's start the lecture from slide number 8. We can also skip some lines because we can't read the whole paragraph. So start the video. For what are formal methods? Formal method in general refer to the use of technique from logic and discrete mathematics to specification, design, construction and analysis of computer system and software. Formal method are very important to avoid incomplete requirement specification and system description. In construct to document written in natural language, formal methods are based on formal languages. Example given, mathematical logic and require the explicit and notation of all assumptions. Reference is also given in the below point. Let's move on the next slide, formal methods is software engineering. I think there's a misprint. Formal methods in software engineering. Formal methods model is an approach to software engineering that applies mathematical methods or techniques to the process of developing complex software system. The approach uses a formal specification language to define each characteristic of the system. Let's move to the slide number 10 because it is continue slide number 9. We are at slide number 10. You can also see on the left side of the video on which we are on the slide number. Formal methods are mathematical approaches to solve software problems at the requirements, specification and design levels. Formal methods are most likely to be applied to safety critical or security critical software and systems such as security softwares. And let's move to the next slide. I hope you can understand. Formal method adopt a three-step approach to modeling and evaluating system. During formal specification, an engineer or designer rigorously define a system using a modeling language. My English is not that strong, so if I mistakenly pronunciate any word wrong, so please. Typically, by using a formal mathematical syntax and semantics that eliminate faults, this is similar to writing down system specification through note in plain English. From there, based on the specification, the engineers develop a set of theorems about the behavior of the system. These theorems are verified through mathematical proofs to ensure that the system behavior is logically consistent and is indeed the desirable one. As this allows designers and engineers to discover flaws in instability even before the design gets implemented into the code. It prevents costly errors from emerging in the later stages of development. Finally, once the model is specified and a verified implementation can begin by converting the specification into code. The highlights words are the meaning for example highlight words are can be questionable in exam. Let's move to the slide number 12. This is continue also of slide number 11. Formal methods are methods that use formulas. A formula is a text or diagram constructed from a predefined symbol combined according to explicit rules. A good working definition of formula is anything whose appearance or syntax can be checked by a computer according to this definition. Every computer program is a formula. If you want this slide, then comment below the video, then I provide you the link so you can download easily from any browser. Let's continue lecture number 13. There are total 21 slides in this lecture and this is lecture number 1. You can also read that lecture number one on the top left of the slide. With formal method, we can determine the meaning of a formula, be it a specification, design, or a program, without executing it. The whole point of using formula method is to be able to predict what a program will do without running any code. Okay. Now this is a main slide also. When to use formal methods? When to use formal methods? Formal methods are useful when problems are difficult or system must meet requirement for safety, security, accuracy, or other critical properties. Novel projects, building something substantially new, when we can't just take an existing system and make some modification. Projects are difficult when they take problems that are profound and deep, or when they present a multitude of intricate details. Critical projects are those where so much is at stake: safety, security, and money. How to use formal method? We can use formal method in three essential activities: modeling, design, and verification. Modeling, design, and verification. And there are also points given below the next slide, slide number 16. Design, partitioning, bottom up refinement, and continuing verification. There is a definition of verification. Verification means showing that our code will do what we intend. Verification detail with the final product of our development code. One of the product of a formal verification is a proof of convincing demonstration based only on the specification and the program text next on executing program. Let's move to slide number 18. I am going so fast because I don't want a long video. Let's move to the slide number 18. Why use formal methods? Creating software is not more difficult than any kind of engineering. Many of our difficulties result from avoidable mistake and poor programming practices. Designers specify a product when they don't fully understand customer real need. Programmer write code when they don't fully understand what it will do, and so on. The fundamental error is reliance on guessing to product system and trial and error to validate and improve them. This approach is not suitable for critical system, and novel and new system to formal method are required. Formal method for project management. You can also pause the video and read the whole paragraph. Three products that must be produced by almost any programming projects are the specification, which describes the behavior of the product, the design, which describes its internal structure, and the code, which is executable and expressed in some particular programming language, G language. And let's move to slide number 20, which is also continuing number slide number 19. In formal plain English text, for formal specification is required. Requirement must be in plain text for user and client to be able to communicate with the requirement gather. Formal method is required for systematic process of code. A good formal specification is no more for a phase of the next. Let's read it on yourself. Let's move to the slide number 21. This is the last slide. It is necessary to show that a formal specification expresses the intent of the requirement. This is called validating the specification. If the requirements are clear and the formal specification is well organized, much of the specification can be validated by inspection. In case where it is not so obvious, we can apply the formal reasoning method thought later. Hope you like the video, and kindly subscribe our channel and share with your classmates which are searching for formal methods. Thank you.